Hello, I would like to welcome you to the Oracle Identity and Access Management Insight session titled REST API-based integration in OIG. My name is Alin Tsara and I'll be your presenter today. Representation state transfer, in short REST, is an architectural style for building web services over HTTP. By using REST API interface, developers can implement secure and flexible integration between different applications and systems. In simple words, REST is any interface between systems using HTTP or HTTPS to obtain data and generate operation on those data in all possible formats, such as XML and JSON. REST API have an increased rate of adoption in industry and continue to gather popularity due to its versatility. More and more applications are offering REST API interfaces. Starting with bundle patch from October 2016, Oracle Identity Governance, or OIM, adds new API, a REST API for self-service requests. The REST services include endpoints to invoke self-service calls for tasks like catalog, request, certification, users, role, organization, others. Identity REST services are based on Scheme protocol. Starting with 12c version, most of the Oracle Identity and Access Management products implement REST API interface. By REST API interface, Oracle products provide a high opportunity to grow existing infrastructure of any organization at the horizontal level. Identity REST services are a set of REST web services that provide functionality for self-services, users, role, group, organization, and password policy management. REST API for OIG was constantly and consistently improved since implementation and covered tasks from below area: self-service, token service, application management, deployment manager, facade web app token service. There are few functions not being implemented yet by REST API. For all such cases, leverage the rich Java API or OIG UI. For more details, please follow the documentation for Oracle Identity Governance. Here are all REST endpoints grouped by API. Next, I will show you by a few examples how OIG REST API can be used. As per requisites for our demo, we need a running OIG environment. In my case, I used an OIG 12c PS4. Next, we need a user with necessary permission. For simplicity in this demo, I use self sysadmin that have all permissions. Last, we need a tool or client to execute REST API calls, such as Postman or Curl or any other tool for REST API. In this demo, I use Postman. First endpoint we will use is a fetch token for authenticated user. So I will go to Postman. And I have here a post query. This is the URL. The host global variable, it's pointing to my OIG system. And we will press send. And here we can see the token was created. Status to 101. And here is access token. The next endpoint, it's get users, and we can obtain all user from identity manager, which are viewable by the logged in user. In our case, as we use Celsius admin, we can see all users. The user can be filtered based on some criteria specified in filter query parameter. So let's see how it's working. Again, Here we put the endpoint. The host global variable contain the details for my environment. This is a get, and we will send the query. The status is 200. It's okay, was executed with success. And in results, we can see the user from the environment. So let's see the query. For example, I'll query for last name, starting with WebLogic. And the result, it's the WebLogic user already existing in system. Last name, this is the attribute used to search and its value. Next query. It's get details for an user based on user ID. So let's see. We will check the existing users and get ID for one of them. Let's check this user. His ID is here. I will save it as a global variable that will be used in get user detail. So here is, we can see the value saved from a previous query. I'll press send. And here are the details for the selected user. Next endpoint is how we can create users. For this, we need to create a payload. I already have it. So I'll create two users. Status 200, executed with success. We have in results the details for the new created user. And for example, I will save this. For next endpoints. Let's see how we can update user. This is the same endpoint, but we use a put query, and we can update one or more user in list and their attributes. So let's see how it's working. So I need to put the values for the ID user. I have two users, I just created, and I will update the first name. And I put an user that does not exist to see how it behaves. The status is 200, and let's see the details. First request was success. And we have here the endpoint for a user. The second user was also a success. And we have here the endpoint. And the third one, it's a fail because it doesn't exist. And we have here the reason. Next endpoint, it's how to patch user to update one or more user with list of user attributes specifying request payload. It's similar as POT. So let's put here the user ID. I want to change last name and put REST API update 02. And do I want to delete first name? And update display name with update 0 REST API. And I have here a non-existing user. I want to see how it's behaving. Because we have already a success command, the status is 200. It's OK. Let's see. The user with ID 3006 was updated with success. The other, it's a fail. Next endpoint, it's a submit request and can be used to request application instance entitlements roles for users. You need to complete a payload with the details. And let's see how it's working. I need to put an existing user. Need to put the entity ID for the application. This is application instance. And the mandatory info from for this application, in this case, is containerdn. And let's send the request. Request this with success. Next endpoint is update user status. Can be used to change status, to update status as lock, unlock, enable, disable for user, specify by user ID. So let's see how it's working. I had unlocked previous this user. Let's set status unlock. Operation is with success. Let's check. It's unlocked. Next endpoint, it's for the deployment manager. We can get a list of all type of entities. So this is used to export or import configuration between environments. So this is the endpoint. There is a payload. And I request these entities. And here are the details exported as XML. Next endpoint. It's export operation on entities. It's a post. And we can export the list of entity based on entity type and entity name. This is the payload. And we request dependencies and put description testing. Here are the results as XML. Next endpoint, it's for application management, and we can get a list of available connectors in a given directory. If no directory specifies the default, and here is the default, and these are the details. Next endpoint, it get application details by name. So we get the details for this application. And that's all for today demo. REST API for OIG is a powerful tool and have continuous and consistent improvements. For more details and sample, please review the OIG documentation in the below URL. Thank you again for tuning into today's Oracle Identity and Access Management Insights session. We look forward to seeing you at the next one.